हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक रीजनिंग एंड आल्सो द बेस थ्योरम हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट द एक्सपेक्टेड प्रोबेबिलिटी टू एनालाइज द गिवन डेटा पैटर्न विच हैज सम अनसर्टेनिटी. सो इफ यू डोंट हैव एग्जैक्ट सर्टेन इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड द डेटा हैज सम अनसर्टेनिटी, इन दैट केस वी यूज प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक रीजनिंग एंड Bayesian theorem. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss the hidden Markov model. So, basically, this model is a class of probabilistic graphical model which is based on probability that allows us to predict a sequence of unknown, that is hidden, variables from a set of observed variables. So, what we do here, basically, in hidden Markov model, we just try to find out a graph in which a layer will be for hidden variables and the last layer will be for the observed variables. So basically, the hidden layer level, the nodes will be hidden nodes or the hidden states, and the last level, final level, the observed states, the nodes will be named as observed nodes. To just see here, so we don't have enough information available to predict the behavior of hidden states over here. So based on some observed states, we are able to predict the behavior of hidden states. That is the benefit of hidden Markov model. For example, suppose we want to predict the weather condition and we don't know the weather parameters. So what are the weather parameters? So what kind of humidity is, what is the temperature now, what if the sky is cloudy or not. So if we don't know the parameters which are required to predict the weather, so in that case we have another alternative, that we can predict the weather condition based on the clothing, that is the cloths that someone wears during that day. So basically we will have two kinds of states over here. So one is hidden states and the other is observed states. So based on the observations through the observed states, we are able to predict the states of conditions of the hidden states over here. Just see. The one other property of hidden Markov model is that it follows a Markov assumption. So what is Markov assumption? Each state only depends on the previous state and not on any other prior states. So in this case, if we talk about here hot, there are three states over here in hidden states: hot, then mild, and then cold. So basically we will have three variables for weather. So it can be hot, it can be mild, and in between hot and cold, and the third is the cold. So here, just see, there is a direct arrow between hot and mild. So what it says, that there is a transition from hot state to mild state. So after hot season, there is a chance to be a mild season. Then there is a direct connection between mild state to cold state. So after mild state, there is a chance to be happened a cold state. So basically, the Markov assumption says that each state only depends on its previous state. So the occurrence of the mild season depends on the hot season. Similarly, the occurrences of the cold season depends on the mild season over here. So this is basically following the Markov assumptions. So now, just see here. The hot state corresponds to the observed state where we have very lightweight clothing. So people will wear a lightweight clothing. It seems that it is a hot season. If people is wearing somehow an average weighted cloth, so we can say that okay, it will be a mild season. Now if the person has wear a heavy weight cloth, it means the season is cold season. So basically, based on these observed cases, we are able to predict the condition of weather state here using hidden Markov model. So just see here, this prediction is based on some probabilities. Basically, there are three kinds of probabilities: the initial probabilities, so, and the second is the transition probabilities, and the third is the emission probability. Just this will be discussed later on in this lecture over here. Just see here, initial probabilities will be, so initial probability will be okay. So initial probability, what we say, if we take a start node over here, so start from start node to hot node probability will be taken as initially. Suppose it is 0.4. So from start node to mid node, it is suppose 0.3. Start node to cold node, it is 0.2. So these are basically initial probability, that is called also called prior probabilities. The second kind of probabilities are transition probabilities, when a transition is happening from one state to another state. We are transiting from one state to another state. Here, from transiting from hot state to mild state, is the probability is 0.3. From mild state to cold state, probability is 0.2. And also we'll have loop probabilities also, hot to hot, mild to mild, and cold to cold. So these are basically called the transition probabilities. And the third is the emission probabilities. Emission probabilities are the probabilities that is labeled along the link from hidden state to observed state. So suppose this is the probability 0.4, this is 0.6, this is 0.7. So we can say that the emission probability here from hot state to the clothing, this clothing state is 0.4, here 0.6. So these are called the emission probabilities. So based on these probabilities, we are able to predict the behavior of hidden state over here. It will be explained in this lecture later on with an example how we can predict the state of hidden, the behavior of hidden states over here. So hidden Markov models are probabilistic models. They allow us to compute the joint probability. Basically, here we calculate the joint probabilities of the set of hidden states by given a set of observed states, and then the highest probability, joint probability, gives the corresponding behavior of the state over here. Now, it requires three types of information. Just we have already discussed the transition data, that is transition probability, the emission data, emission probability, and the initial probability, that is the prior probability. So transition data, probability of transition to new state from the present state. So basically, when a transition is happening from one state to another state, the label probability that will be required to calculate the information over here. Then emission data. So probability of transition from hidden state to observed state. Basically, this kind of probability is called emission probability. And the initial probability prior, that it is also called the prior probability of transiting to hidden state. So basically, these three probabilities will be used in calculating the joint probability and just finding out the behavior of the hidden states over here. Just see what kind of probabilities it can have. Suppose, for example, we have a weather and clothing scenario. So the prior probabilities are for the hot season 0.6, for mid season 0.3, cold season 0.1. And transition, hot to hot transition, the probability is 0.6, hot to mild 0.3, hot to cold 0.1. So similarly for mild to hot, mild to mild, cold to, so these are the probabilities, transition probability basically, which tells us the probability of transition from one state to another state. Now, these are the probabilities of emissions, means if there is a hot season, so what is the probability of wearing the casual wear? So there is a probability is 0.8. So 80% probability is that if there is a hot season, so the people will wear casual wear. Similarly, the 50% chance is there that people will wear the semi-casual wear. And only 1% chance during the hot season, the people will wear the winter apparel. So similarly for the mild season also, the 19% probability for to wear the casual wear, mild season, 40% for semi-casual, 20% for winter apparel, Similarly for cold season also. So these are the probabilities which says that which kind of cloth with the people will wear during this season over here. So just see how we can calculate the joint probability of a sequence. For example, let's say we have the observing states of a sequence are y is equal to y0, y1, y2, dot dot dot, yl minus 1. Basically, there are l observing states of the sequences of length l given by. So these are the basically sequences y0, y1, yl minus 1. These are the l number of sequences, capital L number of sequences, and their joint probability will be calculated by this formula. Probability of y is equal to summation of x, probability of y given x into px. So it says that the x is given. So x is what? X is basically the hidden nodes. So hidden nodes are, x is a sequence of hidden nodes. So let's say x have l minus 1 number of nodes. So x0, x1, x2, dot dot dot, x l minus 1. So there will be l number of hidden nodes available over here. So for each hidden node we will find out the probability, and then we will sum up over here. So for x1, x0, so here the probability will be, probability of py will be calculated. For x1, probability of y will be calculated. So basically this is the conditional probability. Conditional probability says that x is given, x is provided, so find out the probability of y. Y is what? Y is the observed sequences. X is what? S is the set of hidden states. Y is a set of observed states. So this is how we can calculate the joint probability over here. So just see here, this very simple example. These are the two hidden states, healthy state and fever states. And we don't know, we don't have any testing parameters available over here to find out the state of healthy or the fever states. So we have to just we have to just predict the state, hidden state, based on the these observed states. So these observed states are dizzy. If the person is looking like dizzy, if the person is having cold, some cold, if the person is looking some normal, so based on these observed states, we are able to predict whether the person is healthy or the person is the fever. So basically we will draw this kind of diagram over here, graph over here, and based on this graph and finding out the joint probability, we are able to predict the behavior of the state. Just see here, initial probability is it is the probability from a start state to this hidden state. So for healthy state it is 0.6, for fever state it is 0.4. so transition probability from healthy to fever, that is 0.3. from fever to healthy, if a person is healthy, so what is the probability that he will have a fever? So the probability is 30%. If a person is a fever, so what is the probability he will become healthy? So that is the 40%. Similarly, if a person is a fever, so next day the probability of having fever is 0.6. Similarly, if a person is healthy, the next day the probability will be how much? 0.7. So this is what the transition probability given over here. Now if the person is healthy, so what is the probability that he will have some dizzy problem? So dizzy problem, so that is probability is 1%. If the person is healthy, then what is the probability of being cold? So 40%. If the person is healthy, what is the probability that he will be normal? Around 50%. So if the person has fever, so what is the probability that he will have some dizzy behavior? So that is the 0.6. If the person has fever, so what is the probability he will have cold? That is 30%. So if a person is a fever, so what is the probability that he will be normal? Only 1% probability. So basically these are the emission probabilities. Basically they are the labeled of the edges which are connected from hidden state to this observed state. Basically this is your observed states and this is your hidden states. So this is how we can analyze the hidden Markov model based the problem with the hidden Markov model, which is basically in a graph where we have three kinds of information: initial probabilities, transition probabilities and emission probabilities. And based on these information, we just find out the joint probability and predict the behavior of hidden states over here. Thank you.